Hello everyone, Robert Rambles here, and welcome back to WoW Classic Era and our immersive playthrough of Teldrassil. Thank you guys for clicking on the video and joining me here today. I hope you are doing well. We are going to head back into the Barrow Den to start things off. We have to find some shaman. They're going to drop an item, and then we're going to have to kill the physical form of the druid spirit that we talked to previously. After we take care of that, we'll head down here to the southwest, and we'll take on Ursula the Mauler. And then we have a bunch of stuff to do in the northwestern part of the zone, so yeah. Let's get into things. We'll also remember to turn track herbs on, because we did die in spirit res last time. Inventory looks good. Let's take a look at talents. I think we just have to keep going into a spirit tap. The goal here is to make it so that every time we kill something with experience, we're going to get that mana regen. So inevitably, we just want to get 5 points into that as soon as we can. You'll notice that when we do proc Spirit Tap, we actually get a lot of mana back. Spirit Tap is something that would let us eventually go pull the pull. You know, we're not going to have as much downtime once we have that Spirit Tap talent maxed out. I'm really hoping that we'll just naturally get the item that we need by killing these guys on the way in, and that we won't need to farm them. Because that's really all we need here. We need to get the voodoo charm from the shaman, we give that to the guy, and then he has us go kill his body. And so if we can just get the item on the way to the guy, that would be awesome. So I have my fingers crossed for that. Well, we're seeing bodies that we are not responsible for, so there is at least one other player around. Which is kind of unfortunate. We need the shaman. They might need the shaman too at this point. Level 9. We can give them fortitude. But I do need to tag the shaman. And there we go, there's the item. And it should turn in right up ahead. We might not have to clear these other shaman. Thank you, Rambles. What an odd trinket this is. I can sense the vile aura emanating from it. This is a very powerful enchantment. After examining this charm, Rambles, I see now what must be done. Please take it, and do as I ask. You are to explore the deepest areas of the Banathil Barrow Den. There you will find my soulless body. Although I regret what I am about to tell you, I see no other way to free myself from control of the Gnarlpine. In order for me to escape, you must kill my physical form. Once that is done, use the voodoo charm on my fallen body. After you have completed this task, please return to me. And we'll actually get a robe out of that with some intellect. Or some stamina, rather. Sleeping robes. Okay. I'm hoping we can share this because, yeah, that's one of the good things about not being on hardcore is that we can group up with people and help people get their quest done. So yeah, there we go. I almost forgot. I was kind of like in a race to get there, thinking that we had to absolutely tag him first. And then I remembered, no, we can actually invite people to the group. I'm finally free of the control of the Gnarlpine. Thank you, Rambles. My spirit may now rest peacefully forever in the Emerald Dream. Perhaps one day we may meet again, young priest, but for now, please accept this reward as a symbol of my gratitude. There we go. Okay, and yeah, this player might have the right of it. We could hearth out. We could do that. Then again, we don't really need to, because what we want to do is we want to head either down to the south or we want to head up to the north. I think we go do we do Ursa the Mauler first. So let's fight our way out of here. It'll be a little bit of a fight to get out, but I think it'll be okay. now that we're past 50 herbalism, we have to keep in mind that we can gather the mage oil now. So I'll have to stop ignoring that one when I see it pop up. This has been a great place to do herbalism. Lots and lots of herbs. It's probably the best place on the Alliance side to start up with herbalism. I don't know what we did to that guy. We seem to have broken him. He didn't want to cast. He didn't want to move. He didn't really want to do anything. That was a little bit strange. For some reason, I remember fighting somebody in a cave back here, but this named guy, Ursel the Mauler, he does not seem to be in a cave. So I wonder what it is I am thinking about. I remember fighting somebody on the Hardcore Rogue that was a named guy in a cave. But yeah, it's apparently not this one. Alright, I think now would be a good time to hearth back to town. We are getting a little bit low on water, our bags are getting quite full, and I would like to take care of all that stuff before we run off and do anything else. And really the only other stuff here in the zone, I think, is going to be the stuff in the northwestern part of the zone that we haven't explored yet. So we might not be here too much longer. Let's sell everything and we'll restock. And yeah, let's go turn this quest in. That should be enough milk for our next little outing. I don't think this is going to ding us to level 12, but it will be pretty close.
Greetings.
Rambles, you have proven yourself a most worthy and able priest. A night elf who follows the path of honor as sure as you do is certain to find great glory in this world. May the forest spirit protect you wherever your travels may take you. Got a one stamina mace.
Goodbye.
That's pretty cool. There we go. Alright guys, this is going to be a good place for us to take a break for today. Next time we will clear out the northwestern part of the zone, and then I think we might be done here in Teldrassil. It doesn't seem like we've been here that long, but yeah, we're getting to almost level 12. We'll probably be level 13 by the time we finish up here. And level 13 will put us in a good place to head over to Darkshore. So yeah, very exciting. Thank you guys so much for joining me here on this journey. If you're digging the series, leaving a like and subbing to the channel help me out a lot, and I appreciate those that do. Until next time, guys, take care of yourselves out there in the real world, and take care of each other. And we'll see you back here in Azeroth again very soon. Bye for now.